What is up, guys? Max here, and welcome back to part two of creating the Stranger Things title sequence. Let's jump in. In this part, we will be covering how to make the letters at the end of the sequence where they open up and look all cool and go, duh. Okay, cool. And right before we get started, I wanted to mention one thing. I have rebuilt my website into something cool and interactive. So, we now have a blog. So you can go on here, check out my blog. I have all my updates, my giveaways, my videos. It's a really cool, easy way to interact, leave a comment. I'm even writing a blog about the making the Stranger Things animation. So that could be really cool. Brand new. It's still under some work, but we're getting it going. Also, we have a store. So go into the store, and people always ask for my project files. Now, I decided to kind of start selling these files for really cheap, less than the price of a cup of coffee, because it is a really cool and easy way for me to support this channel and make more things like this. So I'm going to give this a go, see how this works. But also, I have freebies. So there's a lot of files that I'll give away for free. For instance, the Olympic Torch file and this Stranger Things file. So this entire project file you can download right now for free. And also, 40% off any order over $10. Enter the promo code PUGSFORLIFE at checkout. And finally, on the homepage, I always have some kind of featured product, and also the giveaway. So enter to win will always be there. Check back for more stuff, and feel free to subscribe to the newsletter where you get all my blog updates, crazy awesome stuff. You'll get all the giveaway updates, all my announcements, videos, etc. They will be there. So go check out my new website. I hope you enjoy it. It was a lot of fun being built. Other than that, let's get this thing done. Go down your timeline about right here on Stranger Things, and we're gonna make this. So what I would do is literally type each letter out individually. So you got an S, and then you duplicate it, move it over, T, scale it down. I'll put it right here and make it fit. Take your S, make it fit. And you kind of get the drift. We're gonna do the same thing we did last time. You know, people just want to type it out and just make it work. I suggest not doing that. Actually, ooh, a V shortcut. Taking your time, making it work. Actually, you know, writing it out. You know, some of these overlap each other, and we're gonna have to work with that. Ooh. My shortcut is a V on my mouse, and it can get pretty annoying when I'm trying to type something. But what we will do a little different is I'm not going to make these letters overlap. I won't do that. Not exactly sure what they did to do that, the way their mask was set up inside of this. But I think it looks great if I do it a little different. Oh, duplicate the S on the bottom because it has the right scale. Move it over. It should fit near perfect. Yep, just like that. And you can kind of see where that's why it overlaps. Or if we just use the align tool somewhere. Show me the align tool. Right there. Cool. You don't look lined up, Mr. E. Mr. E. Overlapping, but we're going to work with it for now. And now we need shapes. So grab this. Shape one. Command E. Grab your anchor point. Move it up.
scale, unhinge that, scale it down. Move your anchor point over to this side, actually, now that I think about it. Command D. Move it over. That side's longer. Look at there. Grab your anchor point. Move it over to right here. Scale. Scale it out to about right there. Right where it needs to be. And by golly, it looks like we have the Stranger Things logo right where it needs to be. So here's the fun part. Can we highlight all these at once and do it? Nope. You gotta do one at a time. Sounds awesome. Oh, man. Okay, so... you suck. Create shape. Create shape. So sweet. We have made our title thingy. Almost. We gotta animate it now. Okay. Actually, I'm gonna get rid of these ones. I want to actually make custom shapes that are actually the right size. So real quick, instead of duplicating it, give me the stroke. Fill, turn it off. Ooh, don't change the color, just turn the fill off. Go over here, get a completely new shape. Completely new shape. What is this? That. This was a thing. There's two of them. It's gone. Okay. And I'm gonna actually highlight all of these and turn the fills off. Except for that last one, apparently. Don't need to turn the last one. Moving my mic over. Don't need to turn the last one off. And highlight all of them again and turn their stroke on. What is this? That looks about right. And I'm going to manipulate these a little bit just to make it my own. So, and take all of these and kind of hide them. But what we're going to do real quick is we're going to pre-compose all of this. So, grab all of this, hit pre-compose, call it clip 8, which is the final thing. Click OK. Undo that because I didn't highlight everything. My bad. Highlight everything. Precompose. Clip. Ah, clip. Oh my god. Clip 8. Clip 8. Better. Much better. And actually, copy this and actually put it into. Take the footage right here and drop it into the thing. Which should put it on the exact spot it needs to be. And also scale it back up to 150% because that'll really screw us up if we don't do that. Boom, it looks pretty good. Alright, so now these need to be all aligned. So unline these and then move them back up. I'm going to actually stretch these out a little bit to right there. No, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine. And we'll align all these. That's aligned. Doesn't look aligned. Could be up one, two. Freaking out, man. Align these two. That R looks pretty low for being down there. Just kind of eyeing it, honestly. I'm tired of getting it perfect. Make sure these are aligned. Kind of like right there. Grab this anchor point. Clip it. Command. Oh, nope. Anchor point. And there is a shortcut to move the anchor point around automatically. Somebody told it to me in a comment. I just don't remember it. I'm sorry. I apologize in advance. And boom. That looks pretty good. We'll use that. Turn this layer back on. Well, this needs to be right here. With the R, it also needs to be a little lower. We will lower the R just because. Ooh, lock you. We don't want to touch you. Cool. We will take this. I will accept the way this looks and, you know, live with it. Okay, so take all of these, hide them. Like the little nudge button, hide everything. Okay, right click new camera. Right click new null object. Actually, we don't need the null object for this one. We'll just manipulate the camera physically. Change it to yellow because it stands out that way, I guess. And at this point in our life, highlight everything to be a 3D layer. And click P on your keyboard on the camera, take your Z, and move it back to right there. Position it. And then go forward in your life, right where it needs to be. Take your Z and move this thing out. This is like a 3D your mama layer. I want it to be about that big. And also I need to keyframe the orientation. So right here, keyframe the orientation, come back. Is that the orientation? Pretty sure. Yes, it's the orientation. Put this right here. All right. Go all the way to the end where everything seems to be in place. Everything needs to be in place right here. So all these elements need to be highlighted. Click P on your keyboard and keyframe their position. All right. So they're all going to be in place at this point in time. Now go back in time and start moving stuff around. I'm talking the R is off screen right here at this time. The S is off screen. These aren't even showing yet. They're kind of annoying right now. So turn these bad boys off like that. Or, you know, like so. The T needs to be over here somewhere. The R is moved over. The A is right here. The N is right there. The G, just click the G. The G is right here. The E is like up here somewhere. What else I'm gonna do is actually highlight all of this and change the stroke to blue for now. It just lets me see the difference in color, something like that. Grab the T, move it right here. ING is right here. Oh, that's confusing. Is that an H? Oh yeah, because the H is right down here. ING stay together. Sort of. The S is off down in La La Land somewhere. Right down here. Boom. Go back in time even further. You can see the N is, ooh, not, don't take that. It's right here. This G is over here. The A is actually right about here. I'm thinking this is the I. Oh yeah, that's the I. The I is gonna be about right here. Where's the N come from? Oh, the N comes out of left field. Be about right here. That G is right here. This letter G is right here. Keep going back in time. And swooping in. R needs to be a little further out. And we'll clean this up here in a little bit, don't worry. Look at that. All right. I kind of like that. Not bad. I mean, like, the S comes probably a little further away, honestly. So click your S, find what layer that is. And this needs to come from a little further away. So at this point in time in its life... Hey! Don't do that. This needs to be over here. This keyframe needs to be deleted. Like that. If we do it right there, I say I like it. I like it a lot. Turn the background off. Grab all these layers. Don't need to appear till about right here. That's with everything. And boom. And. Now we can animate the bars. Oop, turn the background back on so we can see when it actually pops in. Doesn't matter too much as long as it's crossed the plane. So these crosses the plane right there. Go up here to our bars, which are right here. Click S on your keyboard, which they'll be fully formed right about here. Go back in time, right about here. After it's crossed the plane, T needs to be finished right there. Click zero on your scale. Undo this first. My bad. Get rid of these keyframes. Undo. Turn all this off. Now click zero on this. It should go out from the middle. Yep, just like that. Zoom in. Line it up with this keyframe. Zero. And I'm sorry if this is a little more advanced. Just like that. So. Easy ease. Go into your graph editor real fast. Oop, I gotta highlight the keyframes to help me out here. There's that one. There's this one. There's this one. There's this one. This is the speed graph, by the way. And there's that one. And they're all just like, ooh. Highlight all of this. Stroke color. Make it red again. And boom. Just like that. I'm pretty sure the other one keeps getting smaller. Oh, it's gone by then. Up to here. Stretch this out just a little bit. And turn all your layers off by right there. Composition, trim comp to work area. Now we can watch it. Turn the back layer off. Turn the sound off as well. Give this a little go. Then we're gonna clean it up some. Those look weird. I'm not happy with those. Now let's watch the original again. Just to see what we're working with. It's going. All right. I know what we need to fix. Oh, highlight everything and turn it all back on. So, what you do is you get rid of all these middle keyframes that are annoying the rest of your keyframes. Get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of that. Because it's actually going to two different points in the movement, and it's not what you want. So now it's like this. Kind of like that. Give it a little play. Da-na, da-na-na-na-na. Looks pretty good. Turn all these off. Turn the background back on. Give it a watch. This is the original. These seem to end. That one's done moving. This one's done moving. Done, done. Okay, I need to change it up a little bit. Turn all these back on. My eye is totally different. Click on the eye. Click on the eye. The end could be finished, so could the eye. So the eye could be finished right about there. The end could be finished right about here. Right there. T can be finished earlier, right about there. The E can also be finished a little earlier. And these can be going off a little earlier. Not that one, this is the top one. Just like that. Boom. Let's give this a watch. Let's watch it with the background just to see the difference. Not terrible. Pretty close. The eye's a little funky. I think it's really messing it up. The eye is completely different size, it seems. You know. Which can really mess you up. It's going right here. Actually, I bet if we take it down somewhere, like right down here, it'll be a little better. Yeah, I like that a lot more. And I like it. Cool. I'm going to go with this main comp. Move this down on our life. And boom. At this point, page down. Needs to appear. Page down it does. Right there. We can turn this bad boy off in the background. Actually watch this thing. And when it fades out, right about there. So boom. 100%. Zoom in. Out. Ease out. Ease in. Sweet. All we need now is the title sequence. Or the titles where you can put in your things. So, really simple. It is Helvetica. New. A. Maxwell. Helvetica. I think bold. Make it a little smaller until the A matches up. That's pretty spot on. Well, let's just go ahead and do the Netflix. Ooh, that's a little different. We'll just use it just like that. Ridgeway. Now, is it Helvetica new exactly? Apparently not. But it's pretty darn close. Maybe it's not bold. Regular? Nope, definitely not. Just like that. It appears. This is actually the easy part, to be honest with you. It's 100% right there. Then it's 0% right here. Also, we can cut it off. Hey Siri, chill out. I don't need you right now. Thanks. So it goes in, boom. And goes out. Right there. And it's gone. And what we'll do is just literally copy and paste all of this as we go. We'll go ahead and make the effect as well. So 100% down to 0. Also, what we'll do is go to fill onto this. We'll do this like darker gray. Then keyframe your fill right here. Keyframe your fill right here. Effects, fill, color, keyframe the value. Drop it to right here. Take this value, turn it red. Then it's gonna do that, just like the other thing. And turn it red. Like that. Then what you can do is literally just copy and paste this bad boy throughout your thing. So he appears here. You can literally just Command C V, pop it in. It should be the same amount of time. You can always just extend it. So it goes to right there. Click U on your keyboard and drag these out to right here. And I will speed this up so you can see. I'm also going to change the font on some of them because they have a different Helvetica on the thing. But yeah, you'll see. Oh, and one more thing. Make sure when you type this, it is the character or the thing is centered. Because if it's not and you retype it, it's going to be annoying as heck to center this stuff. So, boom, boom. I will say created by the Duffer Brothers because these men are geniuses. Love their work. Amazing. And just highlight everything. And pre-compose. Call it credits. Oh, and one more thing before I forget this finishing the title sequence. When these letters roll in, they kind of abruptly stop. It's like just a stop, and it's kind of annoying for me. I think in the actual show, it does stop kind of abruptly, and I don't really like that. So I'm going to make it a little better, in my opinion. So highlight all your keyframes on the inside of the letters ending right here. All your keyframes. Also, you need to highlight this one and this one because it's the end of it. Right-click. Keyframe assistant, ease in. So it eases in. Now on this side, highlight all of these and highlight that. Ease out. So when you're watching your title sequence in your main composition, right here, turn the music off. Oh, and by the way, I don't want the music. I totally redid the things. Like, let's read it. Stranger Things opening titles. A Maxwell Ridgway tutorial. Created in After Effects. Please like this video and subscribe. Dang it, it started over. Ugh. I'll just try my best. Okay. A Maxwell Ridgway tutorial. Created in After Effects. Please like this video and subscribe. Don't forget to leave a comment. Smiley face. There's plenty more where that came from. This came from. Oh, 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 yes. And more titles. Co-executive producer. Producer, go watch the show. Executive, hello, executive tour producer. Pokemon Go, Pyro Rainer, Sparky. Remember, have you subscribed yet? Okay, watch. They just softly stop. They're all softly stopping. Because of the new thing. Oh, that's wicked smooth. That's wicked smart, baby. Oh my god. I left this title this because they deserve the credit. This is amazing. All right, so don't forget that little tip. Ease in, ease out. But come back for the next part. Please like and subscribe, and we will make the look, the glow, the effects, the grit, the grain, everything. Executive producer, another guy. Everything that makes this thing awesome, we will recreate.